Well, now, it's only a slight majority, 52%, but it is the first time since January 2007 that more than 50% of respondents to the CNN ORC poll answered positively to the question, how well are things going in the country today? That's up 11 points in the past year.
So let's talk about it with Republican strategist and the senior director of BlackRock Group, Lisa Booth, and CNN Hi. Political commentator and Democratic strategist, Maria Cardona. Good morning, ladies. So good to have you here.
Good morning.
Good morning, Lisa. So you heard the numbers here, right? Which they kind of flies in the face of the results from the midterm elections with Republicans now in control of both houses. So if people thought that we were headed in the right direction, Lisa, why the change?
Right. Well, I think you're absolutely right. You know, and it's always positive news if Americans feel more comfortable about the direction the country is heading. But that doesn't mean we're on the right trajectory, as evidenced by the midterm elections. I mean, look, the midterm elections were absolutely a referendum on President Obama and Democrats' failed policy and lack of leadership on issues like Obamacare, ISIS, and the economy. And what Republicans did is they really messaged on, you know, a message of opportunity, a message of changing the trajectory of the country, a message of a new direction, a new leadership. And as a result, you know, Republicans have a larger majority in the House than most Americans have seen in their lifetime. And we're on track to pick up 9 seats in the Senate.
So, Maria, I want to ask you about something that Senator Chuck Schumer said earlier. He blamed Obamacare, mm-hmm. basically, for the midterm loss. And I want to quote him here. He said, quote, to aim a huge change in mandate at such a small percentage of the electorate made no political sense. So when Democrats focused on health care, the average middle class person thought the Democrats are not paying enough attention to me. What do you say to that, Maria?
I don't agree with that, and I actually agree with Leader Pelosi, who had a response to him when she said, actually, Democrats are focusing on the economy. And going back to the poll that you just mentioned, Christy, you know, it is unfortunate because what happens is that there's always a lapse between the time when things actually start getting better with all of the data, and we've been seeing the positive data for quite a while now, where you have 55 straight months of private sector job creation. You have the largest GDP growth in the last quarter that we've seen in 10 years. And now what we see is that Americans are really starting to feel that. What we saw in the midterm elections is that after so much of a hoopla from Republicans in terms of focusing on Obamacare and Obamacare and Obamacare, very few campaigns were actually about Obamacare. And in fact, in polls, you see that the majority of the people actually do like the specifics of the Affordable Care Act and don't want to see it repealed, perhaps might want to see things change in it a little bit, but they understand that a lot of Americans who didn't have health care protections, 14 million, that actually do have it now is a good thing for the economy. So I think Democrats actually needed to focus more on the positive economic news that has been coming out in the past year or so, and maybe the American people would have felt this change a little bit earlier on.
Well, Lisa and Maria mentioned it. Nancy Pelosi said, we came here to do a job, not keep a job. There are 14 million reasons why that's wrong, responding to Schumer and what he had to say. And, of course, in the 14 million, she was referencing people who now have health care coverage. What do you say? I mean, is there an intra-party feud going on here with Democrats?
Well, I think there is to a certain extent, and Nancy Pelosi is right. A lot of people lost their jobs as a result of Obamacare. And look, Senator Chuck Schumer's comments are both ironic and also disingenuous, because it was Senator Chuck Schumer in 2010, he was the one that said that Obamacare would be a positive thing for middle-class families. He also said that it would be a liability to vote against Obamacare, but in fact, it was a liability for the Democrats who voted for Obamacare, as evidenced by the 2014 midterm elections. And look, middle-class families aren't better off. If you look at, you know, insurance premiums are set to increase by double digits in 2015, and Americans have soundly rejected Obamacare repeatedly in the 2014 and 2010 elections. And as Senator Chuck Schumer pointed out, the 85% of Americans were happy with their health care before Obamacare, and also only, you know, 5% of voters lacked insurance before the implementation of Obamacare. This isn't what Americans wanted.
Mm-hmm.